Good morning, everyone. Welcome to our gathering this morning, to those joining us in the building and on Zoom. It is both my honour and privilege to be leading our all-age gathering this morning. For those of you who don't know me, I'm Sarah, and I am one of the youth workers here and one of the deacons. I will be leading our all-age gathering this morning as we continue our series on stories that transform. Our parable for this morning's gathering is the unforgiving servant. This is a massive topic, and I am aware that it is not an easy one. For many of us, forgiveness will take time, and healing will need to be done as well. Forgiveness is not stress-free, and reconciliation isn't always possible, or even appropriate. So please do not mishear me as we wrestle with this during our gathering this morning. As with every all-age gathering, there'll be some things that appeal to everyone, and there'll be some parts that will just appeal to our young people. There is a craft setup at the front where, if you want to, you can make a cross picture using the paint and the sponges, and you go around the edge of the cross with the paint. It does look amazing. Yeah, slightly biased on that one. As we gather this morning, let us take a moment to pause and reflect on our weeks. Let us pray. Lord, thank you that we are able to come and worship you this morning. Thank you that you have been with us in our weeks and that you know what is on our hearts. As we gather in this place this morning, we come to worship you and to listen to your voice. Let us not be fearful in worship and be ready to sing and shout to you. We ask that your Holy Spirit will move among us all in this church building, and that we will be ready to listen to what you are saying to us throughout our gathering today. Please enable us to be ready to respond to you and hear what you want us to hear. We also pray that we will be able to hear how we can forgive more like you. In Jesus' name, amen. But as we gather in this place this morning, let us open up our time together with our call to worship. Our call to worship this morning is slightly different, as there are parts that are for us to respond to as well. Praise the Lord, my soul.
All my inmost
praise the Lord, my soul, and forget not all his benefits. Who redeems your life from the pit.
And has you with love and compassion.
Who satisfies your desires with good things, so that your youth is renewed like the eagles. So, if you are able to, please join me in standing as we sing the first of two songs, When I Was Lost. We will then sing Give Thanks with a Grateful Heart.
Oh,
please be seated. I wonder how many young people and children have ever faced a really, really tough playtime where you've fallen out with your friends, or someone has done something to hurt you, or maybe even said something nasty or mean to you, or about you. I don't want you to share this with me, but I want you to think about where you are at in forgiving them. Is reconciliation possible? Now, I am not saying that forgiveness is always easy, quick, and that reconciliation is always required. Because when someone has done something that is really hurtful, it is not always easy to be the one to forgive, or even to be reconciled to them. Forgiveness is not about condoning the behaviour or saying that the behaviour is okay. There are some situations where it is easier to be civil to the person who has hurt you when you are around others, but when you are on your own, it is easier not to be civil to them because of what has happened. It is sometimes easier to forgive them than to be reconciled. Now, I know this from personal experience. Reconciliation is a two-way process, whereas forgiveness is down to one person. Reconciliation requires the person who has hurt us to apologise and want to make the problem okay. How often does this happen? Not very. As I've already said, forgiveness is not easy, and it takes time and sometimes needs us to go over the problem again for it to be resolved. And now Layla is going to lead us in prayer.
Let us pray. Lord, thank you for forgiving us and bringing us back into relationships with you. Thank you for sending your son to die on the cross to show us the true meaning of forgiveness. Help me to show the same forgiveness to others so that they can see you living in me. In Jesus' name, amen.
Thanks, Layla. Please stand as we sing our next two songs, Thank You for Saving Me and Before the Throne of God I Stand.
You are my everything. I will sing your
seated. Isn't it amazing to think that God chose to save us all and that he forgave us and brought us back into relationship with him? I wonder if any of you know what the Bible says about forgiveness. Please shout out your answers at me, please. Yeah, 70 times 7.
My son was lost, but he's come back.
Yeah. Yeah? Any of the young people? Not looking at anyone in particular. Kira. I'll just see if anyone on Zoom has sent their thoughts. So Maureen's put, thank you God for Layla's prayer. Wonderful, bless you Lord. So, let's take a look at what the Bible says about forgiveness. Can I invite the Castle Hill players up to the stage, please, who will be performing the parable of the unforgiving servant. Guys, up you come. Please don't leave me as Billy No Mates. Yeah.
There once was a king who decided to settle accounts with the men who served him. Well, on the outset, there appeared before the master a man whose debts ran into the millions. I said the millions. Since the man had no means of paying the money, the master then ordered him to be sold to meet the debts with his wife and his child. And everything he had. Well, the man threw himself at the master's feet and said,
"Oh, be patient with me,"
he said,
"and I will pay you in full."
So the master, moved with pity, that he decided to free the man, get rid of the debt. So let's hear it for the master.
Wait a minute, that's not the end of the story. No sooner had the man gone out, he met a fellow servant who owed him a few measly pounds. He gripped him by the throat and said,
"Pay me what you owe me."
But the man threw himself onto the floor and begged him, saying,
"Be patient with me, and I will pay you."
But he refused and jailed him until he could pay his debts.
Well, the other servants were deeply upset and distressed when they had seen what had happened. So they ran and told their master the whole story, and of course, he said, "For the man."
Scoundrel.
He said to him,
"I cancelled all your debt when you met me. Why should you not show him your same kindness?"
And so angry was the master that he sentenced the men to jail until he could pay the debts in full. Dun, dun, dun.
And that's how our Heavenly Father will deal with you, unless you forgive each other from the bottom of your hearts.
Thank you very much, guys. Didn't they do a fab job? Before we look at what the Bible says about forgiveness, I wonder how closely you were all listening to the parable. It's time to play the Bible quiz. Can we have the first question up, please? What did the king do to the servant who owed him 10,000 bags of gold? Was it A, he took pity on him, cancelled the debt and let him go? Or was it B, he sold the man and his family as slaves? So, if you said A, you are correct. Next question, please. What did this servant do to his fellow servant who owed him a small amount of money? Was it A, he forgave him and cancelled the debt, or B, he put his fellow servant in prison? It was B. Just wanted to catch you out. Well done, Joyce. Joyce is on Zoom and she's answering the quiz as we're going along as well. Why was the king angry with the first servant? Is it A, the servant did not show mercy to his fellow servant, even though he had received much mercy from the king? Or was it B, the servant was ungrateful and did not thank the king? It is A. So, okay, you were all paying attention. Very impressed. So, yep, well done, Joyce. 3 out of 3. Knowing that you won. Did you know that we are commanded to forgive? The Bible is really clear that if we are unwilling to forgive others, we have no reason to expect that God will forgive us. Colossians 3:13 states this: bear with each other and forgive one another. If any of you has a grievance against someone, forgive as the Lord forgave you. Psalm 103 verse 12 says that as far as the east is from the west, so far has he removed our transgressions from us. When we choose not to forgive, it is like going into a fight with someone. Whereas God chose to outstretch his arms on the cross to die for us so that we can all be made right with him. God calls us to forgive just as he forgave us. Let us just pause as we reflect on what this means for us. Let us pray. Lord, how can we ever thank you enough? You endured more pain, more shame, more grief than we can ever possibly understand. Help us to remember why you gave your life. Because of love, because of mercy, and because we need them both. We thank you for showing us such amazing forgiveness by extending it to us. Help us to forgive freely and let go of the hurt that we may be facing, and grant us the strength to trust your way is the best. In Jesus' name, amen. Let us join together in the prayer that Jesus taught us. The words will be on the screen. Our Father in heaven, hallowed be your name. Your kingdom come, your will be done, on earth as in heaven. Give us today our daily bread. Forgive us our sins, as we forgive those who sin against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. Amen. Please join me as we sing our penultimate hymn once again. Seated. Before we sing our final song, I have a few items to highlight from the newsletter this week. This coming Wednesday, the 7th of June, we'll be hosting a teenage wellbeing workshop for parents and carers run by the Christian charity Flourish. I want to say it's in the back room. David, I'm looking to you. In the back room. Thank you. Please see the newsletter for more information and to book on it. On Sunday the 11th of June, we are hoping to be able to meet at St. Nicholas Park for a picnic in the park, which everyone is invited to join. And just a reminder to all those people who drive, it is the Two Castles Run next Sunday, so please allow a lot more time to get here, because as I've seen all the maps going up, everywhere locally is going to be closed. Yay! Now, my dad would like to give a notice about an exciting adventure happening in July. Yeah, please. I didn't tell him this, can I just point out?
So on the 18th of July, we're taking the coach to the Cotswolds, and you're all invited. Doesn't matter what age you are. Unfortunate if you have to go to work or go to school, but anybody is welcome to come. We've got 34 people going currently, so it's going to cost about £15 for the coach. And we're going to Batsford Arboretum for coffee. We're going to Evesham Valley for lunch and to have a look round. And we'll be back around 2:30, 2:45. If you want to go, see me.
Thanks, Dad. Have I missed any notices at all that anyone's got? The final one is a massive thank you from Cathy to all those who attended the garden sale at her house. She did send me an email and say how much it was raised. I can't remember. Sorry, Cathy. So please join me as we sing our final song, God is Good All the Time. Seated. If anyone would like to come up to the front and do the cross, please do. There is really, really brightly coloured paint as well. So, yes, Lord, you are good all the time. Please join me again in standing as we close our service with the grace. May the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with us all evermore. Amen.